Have you ever felt overwhelmed with the wine choices you have when you walk into a supermarket? Well, today we're going to share with you a few tips on what to expect, how to choose, and also how to read a few wine labels. If you click on this video, I would imagine you are not looking for a wine that can age for 10 to 15 years, or to open it up in your next wedding anniversary. You may be looking for a wine that you want to pair for a very simple dinner for tonight, or a party with friends. And the appellations, and you know, especially in the old world, can be very confusing. I'm in Paris now. I wonder what is better than going out to a local supermarket and find out what they have. To a local Parisian local supermarket. It's a very small supermarket. Let's start with Bordeaux. Bordeaux is a very famous wine producing region in France and is one of the most famous wine producing region in the world. And a lot of people know this region mainly is because there are a lot of well-known chateaus, there are a lot of big brand names, so it makes the region really famous. But what people don't know is the majority of the wine is actually very basic, like Bordeaux AOC or Bordeaux Supérieur AOC. They're very basic wines, and that's 80% of the total production in Bordeaux. So when you go to a supermarket, you want to go to buy a Bordeaux wine, it's very likely that you're going to buy some very basic wines, and obviously that's really what you're looking for when you go to the supermarket. I think it can be very challenging for a normal consumer to buy a good Bordeaux wine, especially in a normal supermarket. And unless you know the region really well and you know the chateau, the brand names very well, most likely you're just gonna buy very basic wines. Now, unless when you buy a bottle of wine, you really wanna see the word Bordeaux on the bottle, I would actually, you know, go for something that is more around Bordeaux. So, for example, Côte de Beau, Côte de Blaye, they're kind of like Bordeaux wines, but they are actually not in the Bordeaux main region, but they are actually surrounding the Bordeaux area. So you get quite some good value red wines, I would say, that is like Bordeaux, but can be slightly better than the average or the standard classic Bordeaux wine that is labeled as Bordeaux AOC. Now, the hints to buy wines that are around the Bordeaux region will be the word Cotes, so C-O-T-E-S, so that actually means like the hill slope of the area. So it's not a word that is only used for Bordeaux wines, but it's a gift, you know, some hints that you can refer to when you buy Bordeaux wine, for example, like Côte de Beau, Côte de Blaye, this kind of appellations. Now, a lot of you actually may have seen the word Grand Cru. So Grand Cru is usually referred to in a very good wines. You know, actually, and in any case, that's a very good association with very good quality wines, that's especially in Bordeaux, you know, the Grand Cru Classe, you know, like the chateau, the very few renowned chateau, like Chateau Latour, Chateau Lafitte of Chile. Now, the problem is there's actually one exception, or a very major exception in Bordeaux, that you cannot actually think that Grand Cru must mean something of exceptional quality. For example, Saint-Emilion Grand Cru. So what it really means is just that the alcohol level is slightly higher. It means when they harvest the grapes, they are riper, so the alcohol level is higher. So that's just really what it means. Now, if you are up for white wines in Bordeaux, there are some quite good white wines in Bordeaux. I mean, it's the production is not that big compared to the red wines. It's just around 10% of the total Bordeaux production. So look out for the label that says Entre deux mers. So that's a region that is in Bordeaux that is very famous for producing white wines, and you can find some pretty decent white wines in the supermarket from that region. If you're up for the great like Sauvignon Blanc, because that's what they're famous for, and that's what they use to produce Bordeaux white wines. Now let's move on to Burgundy, Bourgogne. So it's a region that is famous for Pinot Noir. Now again, we see the word Côte again, so this time it's like Haute Côte de Bourgogne, Haute Côte de Nuit. So it kind of gives away, you know, like what we saw in Bordeaux, that is not directly located in the main region of Burgundy. It is the sub-region surrounding the main producing region. So we're expecting some quite basic Pinot Noir and Chardonnay production from this region. And you also see some other names, other labels like Bourgogne Alicoté. So Alicoté is a grape name. You know, so this region doesn't only produce Pinot Noir and Chardonnay, they also produce some other grapes, even though the production percentage may be lower than Pinot Noir and Chardonnay. I guess for Burgundy, Bourgogne, it's very hard for us to actually find very, very good quality. I mean, we're not finding very, very good quality anyway in the supermarket, but it's harder for us to find good quality wines, I would say, in the supermarket, just because Pinot Noir on its own is quite hard to grow and quite challenging for the winemaker to make in general. So the price range will be slightly higher even for a rather standard or basic Burgundy wine. I would say if you really want to look for something that, you know, more enjoyable, like the Chardonnay from Burgundy region, you do have to remember a few names, like a few region that is famous for Chardonnay, like Chablis and Puy-en-Velay. So these are the names that are actually within the region itself and is actually delimited, and you will know that, you know, this is quality and they have certain regulations and rules to make sure that they have reached certain standards, and that will be something that you may want to look for if you want to look for something slightly better than an average supermarket wine. Now the next will be my favorite, which is Côte du Rhône. It's my favorite because at the same price range you can find better quality Côte du Rhône compared to maybe Bordeaux or Burgundy, just because Côte du Rhône is located in south of France and the weather is slightly warmer than Bordeaux and Burgundy, because Bordeaux and Burgundy have very challenging climate to grow wines, and whereas Côte du Rhône is in south of France, it's warm, there are less diseases, so I mean it's easier for them to make wines of a certain quality year on year. And in the supermarket, if I really run out of ideas of what to choose and I just want something quite enjoyable at a very good price range, I would actually go for Côte du Rhône. And if you fetch out slightly more money, you can get Côte du Rhône Village, which is actually like the word village is village. So it's a more restricted area in south of France, Côte du Rhône, and I mean the regulation and rules and it's just more strict, so the quality of wine is just slightly better. So I would highly recommend, it's red wine, the main grape is Ganache, it's full of red fruits, it's very easy to drink, and it pairs well with a very simple dinner with meat. So next will be Rosé. So Rosé is very trendy Now, especially during the summer, you don't want to go for white wine, you don't want to go for red wine. You want something in the middle, that will be Rosé. So Rosé is made from red grapes, but the way they make it is slightly different from a normal red wine production, so hence the color is slightly lighter. And the two main regions that I have found this time in the local French supermarket will be Pays d'Oc and Côte de Provence. So Pays d'Oc is also, like, both areas are actually in south of France. So Pays d'Oc, you can see it actually quite often around the world. I mean, not just in France. I think Pays d'Oc you can easily find in any supermarket, really. It's very flexible for them to produce anything. And you can find that in a local supermarket for a very low price range. The quality varies, so I guess it depends if you are being very adventurous. You can find, you know, different types of Rosé that is made out of different grapes. Then that's really the region that you want to go to. And the other region that is very famous for Rosé is Côte de Provence. It's a delimited area. Well, it's actually what I would say it's an area that is super famous of making Rosé. And the price range will be slightly higher, but you will get some very classic Rosé wine from the south of France. So, well, it's really up to you if you want to explore, you know, different grape varieties. You know, I think both regions can offer some very interesting Rosé wines. Now, if you absolutely run out of idea of what to buy, I find some very interesting wines that are actually labeled as bio. So in France, bio means organic. So to produce an organic wine or to have the label bio in France, they have to actually go through some regulation control to make sure that they have met certain standards. For example, they cannot use synthetic chemicals, herbicides, and so on and so forth. So, you know, for a wine producer that actually goes through the process of actually making bio, so organic wine, I think it's something that is worth exploring. And I also think that it also shows that they have made the effort to make good quality wines, or they try to make good quality wines. So if you really, really run out of idea of what to buy, I think bio, the green logo, will be something that you may want to look for when you buy wines in the supermarket. Now the last one will be wines in the boxes. Well, we also can call it like Tetra Paks. So they are quite common, and you see it more and more often these days in supermarkets. What is my opinion on those wines? Well, I would say, you know, if you are planning to drink it now, that will be something that is okay. I mean, if it's a party, you have like many people, I mean, that's just very convenient, right? Like you just buy like a box and then you just serve a lot of people. But then again, you know, very good quality wines wouldn't probably not be packed in Tetra Paks, just because the shelf life is very short. We're talking about 18 months from the moment they pack the box. So, you know, it's better to consume immediately. It's not something that you're meant for aging or anything else that is very fancy, really. But if you are looking for something that does serve for, like, a lot of people, something for fun, for parties, I would say why not? Just that, you know, you should know what you should be expecting when you buy those carton boxes wines, and we are all good. I hope you liked the video. I hope that the information was not too complicated. I understand the French appellations, or not just only the French appellations, wine appellations in general can be rather confusing and complicated. And I would say if we want to know what we are buying and what to expect from wine, we do need some basic knowledge of some label. I hope that you have learned something from the video, and I'll see you again soon.